Assalamu alaikum and hello everyone. So this is my last and final video tutorial related to the strings. So in this I will be starting with the remaining functions for slicing and checking substrings, and then I will be moving to string to numeric and format. So let's start with this slicing stuff. What is the slicing of string? So for example, you have this string s word, and then you can check this the length of string. So this length function will give you the length of all the characters, the count of all the characters. For example, 1 2 3 4 5, so there are 5 characters in this string, so you will get the count of all these 5 with this length function. And if you want to get some substring, so how you can access the substring in this by the indexes. So let me, I have one diagram for you. So for example, here I have this diagram. If you see this if this word, in this word, this W is at index 0, then O at 1, then R at 2, this L at 3, and this D at 4. So this is the what are the indexes of each of these characters. So there is also a negative indexing that you also need to remember. So negative indexing is so it works like this: the total length of this word minus this index, this index minus the total length. So total length was 5, as we already saw here. So 5 minus 0 minus 5, 5 minus 0 minus 5 will be minus 0 minus 5 will be minus 5, 1 minus 5 will be minus 4, 2 minus 5 will be minus 3. So this is how the last character in this string will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and it will go till the final length. So this is how this positive indexing and negative indexing is associated with these strings. So if you want to substring from this s is equal to 2 to 4, this will give me this 2 and 3, but this till 4 means this 4 is not included, so it will only give me RL. Let me run this s, and the expected is RL, as we see 2 and second and third. So this is how it is sliced by indexing. And if you want to get all the characters starting from index 3 till index 8, 8 is not included till 7, and you will get this from third. So this is 0, 1, 2, and third is L, D, and the other after the index 4, you don't have any characters, so they will not be displayed here. So it will not give error. So this is how you can index your substrings. How you can make a substring using indexing, and also you can use this negative indexing. So what does this mean? S minus 3 till minus 1. So let me see that diagram again. So minus 3 means it will starting from minus 3 and it will go till minus 1, but this minus 1 will not be included, so it will only show me this RL as it was in the case of 2 4. So let's start this again, and you will see this RL again. So this is how you can slice the string into substrings using indexing. And I also told you the positive indexing as well as negative indexing. Then the next is how to check if your string contains the substring. For example, this S is your string with word, and you want to check if this WO is inside this string. So in keyword is used for this purpose, and it gives true or false. If it is there, it will give us a true. If it is not there, it will give me a false. So shift enter true, because WO is there. If let me make this O capital, and let me check again, shift enter, so it will give me false because O is a capital now. So I don't have WO in this this substring inside this main string. So this is how you can use this in to check if you have the substring available in the main string. Okay, then you can use this find function as well to check if substring is there or no. So this, what this sub, this find function will return you the starting index of that your first character. So for example, you want to check RLD is there or not. So let me press shift enter. So it will give me 2. 2 means in the main string from 2, 0, 1, 2, it is this substring is starting. And if you don't, if that substring is not contained in the main string, then it will return -1. So -1 will tell us this capital L and D substring is not there in the main string. So this is how you can check substring using in and find function if you want to check the specific location where it is located. Then I have these two final functions related to how you want, if you have this character string and you want to convert it into integer, then you can use this integer and in brackets you can write this string. Let me try shift enter. So it will give me 15. And then you can also use this float and it will give you this float value. And now if you have string with hello and you want to convert it into integer, let's see what I get. Shift enter and now you see value error. So it says invalid literal for integer with base 10. So it does not recognize, or it do not know how to convert this string to numeric value or integer value. So this gives the error. So if you have a string which contains the numbers, then you can convert it to integer float. Or if it is you have some alphabetic letters, then it will give you error. So this is how you can convert string to numeric. Then you have finally formatting function. So for example, I have string with sen is equal to im with these two brackets. So these two brackets, you want to fill it from a data coming from user or something. So what you have to do is use this format function. So in this format function, you will pass these two parameters, which will be coming here in these brackets. And then it will give you this new string. So these brackets are basically the placeholders for these parameters from this format function. So let me run this, shift enter. So I am data analyst. So this is how you can format your string. Then for example, I have this new string and you can give this specific position as well, 0, 1. And let me check this. So I'm data analyst. So let me check this, change this to 1 and this to 0. So now in your, from your parameters, this is place 0 and this is 1. So 1 will be coming first now and 0 will be coming here. So this is how you can switch the positions as well. So I'm analyst data. So that's it from my side. We have covered almost all the important functions related to strings. In last 3 video tutorials, we started with low and upper, then concatenation, replication, split, strip, checking substring, and then how to use slicing to get substrings. And then we also saw the replace function, and then how to convert strings to numeric, which is also very useful when you are dealing with a lot of data and you are reading that numeric data in the form of character and you want to convert back to numeric to perform some mathematical operations. And then finally the formatting function we saw at the end. So I will be stopping here. If you have any question, you can comment below, and stay tuned for more interesting videos.